Welcome to your next C-Sharp project. I'm Andrew Stellman, author of Head First C-Sharp. In this project, we're going to build a console app to pick random cards. Then we're going to reuse the class for picking those cards in a new MAUI app. Start by creating a new console app. Make sure you check the Do Not Use Top Level Statements box to match the code in the book. And you can get a full PDF of this project. Download the first four chapters of Head First C-Sharp from our GitHub page. We asked you to not use top-level statements so you could see Visual Studio generating a class for you. It creates a class called Program. The main method is the first thing that gets run when your app is run. Right-click on the project name in the Solution Explorer and add a new class to your app called CardPicker. Remove the unnecessary using statements at the top of the file by clicking the Quick Actions menu and choosing Remove Unnecessary Usings. You'll see a preview, and then it'll remove the using statements at the top of the file. Convert the file to a file scoped namespace, which removes some brackets and indents so the code matches the book. Start writing the class. It has a method called picksomeCards that takes an int parameter, number of cards. Use a for loop to add random card names to a string array variable called pickedCards, which it will return. The code will call two methods that you haven't created yet, called randomValue and randomSuit. Generate those missing methods by right-clicking on each one of them and choosing the Generate Method Quick Action. The IDE generates methods that have a single throw statement in them. You'll delete the throw statements and fill in those methods. The randomSuit method generates a random number from 1 to 4. It uses if statements to convert that number into a string containing either spades, hearts, clubs, or diamonds and returns it. The randomValue method generates a random number from 1 to 13. If the number is 1, 11, 12, or 13, it returns it as a named card, ace, jack, queen, or king. Otherwise, it just returns the value. Go back to your main method and write the code for the app. It prompts the user to enter a number of cards to pick, then tries to convert the string the user has entered into a number. If it's a valid number, it calls that method you just added in the CardPicker class, then uses a for each loop to print each card to the console. If the number isn't valid, it writes a message to the console asking the user to enter a valid number. Run your app, enter a number, and you should see it generate a set of random cards. Close your console app. Your CardPicker class is done. Now you're going to reuse it in a .NET MAUI app. Close the project and create a new .NET MAUI app called Pick Random Cards MAUI. Once the IDE finishes creating the app, open mainpage.xaml and remove the existing controls. Then add a new label that will show the user a prompt asking how many cards to pick. Make sure you enter the semantic properties and give it some visual options like font size and horizontal options. Add an entry control. The user will use this entry control to enter the number of cards to pick. You'll need a button control. Once the user enters a number, they'll click this button to pick random cards. Add a clicked event handler and choose new event handler so Visual Studio generates a new event handler method for you in the C# code. Finally, add one more label control. This will be a multi-line label that shows the random cards returned by your CardPicker class in white text on a dark blue background. Next, go to AppShell.xaml and edit the title. We set the title to Pick a Card! With a red background color. Open mainpage.xaml.cs and delete all the unused code. Remove everything except that main page method and the clicked event handler that the IDE added for you. Run your app to make sure it works. You'll see all the controls you added, but they don't do anything yet. Close the app, then go to the Solution Explorer, right-click on the project name, and choose Existing Item from the Add menu. Navigate to the project folder from your console app, and select cardpicker.cs. That's the class file that has your CardPicker class. Once you add the file, you'll see it in the Solution Explorer. Now go to the event handler code and try to call the cardpicker.picksomeCard methods. Hold on, IntelliSense isn't working. That's because the CardPicker class is in a different namespace than the rest of your app. Fix this by adding a using statement to the top of the file. Add using pickRandomCard semicolon to the top of mainpage.xaml.cs. Now IntelliSense works with the class. The code in your main page can use the CardPicker class in the file you added, and you can finish the button's event handler method. The clicked event handler method uses int.tryParse to read the number in the entry control, just like your console app did with the user input from the console. The button calls the picksomeCards method just like your console app did, and updates the label to add the card names. Use environment.newline to add a line between each card. Add a line at the end that shows how many cards the user picked. Just like your console app, it has an if-else statement that tells the user to add a valid number if they entered one that was invalid. Run your app and enter a number of cards to pick, then click the Pick Some Cards button. The app will call the code from the CardPicker class you reused to generate card names and display them in the label. Try entering something that's not a number. It will show you the message asking you to enter a valid number. Congratulations, you've now reused a class from a console app in a .NET MAUI app. Thanks for watching, like and subscribe for more videos, and check out our GitHub page for free downloads.